Hello, this is Katz from Yokoso News. Today is Sunday, May 23rd, 2010. We are here at the Royalty in Culver City, USA to cover the book release party of this book called Cosplay in America. Photographer Ejen traveled around the US to take a picture of cosplay player all around America. So he's having the release party. Music by Tune in Tokyo, the J-pop music group happening in LA, and there are gonna be lots of cosplay players hanging out in the Royalty too, so we're gonna go cover it. So you have a great, nice opening today.
Thank you. I hope it goes well.
So would you introduce yourself?
My name is Ejen. I spent five months in 2009 traveling to six conventions in America. And those are, Anime Expo, Fanime, Acon, AFES, Otakon, AWA, Anime Weekend Atlanta. And I photographed about 1,600 cosplayers. And then I spent 6 months kind of editing down to about 260, which are in a book. And, you know, it's a hardcover, 272 pages. Whew, it's like a year of my life writing that book. It's crazy.
I mean, why did you decide to do it, and what was the process of making it?
Really quickly, there's no book about cosplay in America. Like, they're all from overseas. Every time I find a book, it's not here. So, why not? I had credit cards. They're open. Might as well do one. So the whole process was basically, I just went on a lark and did it. It's kind of crazy. But it seemed to work. So after this, I start traveling around to conventions and then selling a book at artist alley tables. And that's going to be fun because I'm telling you, so I spent a year photographing. Now I want to get back out again to conventions. Of course, I'll be in artist alley tables, so I won't be out taking pictures as much as I used to, but I'm still going to have fun no matter what, you know.
Yeah, I mean, I agree because there are so many cosplayers all over the world. I mean, in Nagoya in July, they're going to have a World Cosplay Summit. So obviously, we have a World Cosplay Summit. That means people from all over the world was doing the cosplay. But not so many people were having the book published and report about what's going on in the foreign country. And you are the first one in the US to do it. I'm really a pleasure and happy to see you work. But how's the turnaround?
The turnout?
Yeah.
You know what? It's kind of amazing. I didn't expect that many people show up, and then you know, LA Weekly show up, and then a couple of other blogs are showing up. Did you talk to the guy from New Jersey? I actually had a cosplayer fly out from New Jersey, which I'm in complete shock. I'm like, wow, for me? Wow. You know, it's kind of crazy, but it's kind of fun too.
So when did the book came out? Is it out in Japan too?
If they want to buy it in Japan, they can buy it in Japan off my website, cosplayingamerica.com, and I can ship it overseas. The main shipment comes in this week, so I only have like the advanced shipment this time.
Who are you? Would you introduce yourself?
My name is Ejen. I'm a photographer, basically. Basically, that's it. I'm a photographer who decided to make a project. It's a kind of crazy idea. I just kind of did it.
Well, can I talk about your Twitter account that you do?
Yeah. Oh, that's right. Basically, I think like 5,000 people following me on various, like, you know, Twitter, Facebook, MySpace, Model Mayhem, Flickr, YouTube, DA. Am I missing one? I think I pretty much covered it all. So I'm on it all the time, almost every day. Actually, every day I'm on it, constantly. So, and I'm talking to people. This is kind of weird because I've asked cosplayers their opinion and asked them questions about, you know, certain things because I want to get input from the community. I didn't want it to be just like me going off and doing my own book. I wanted to get some ideas from other people too. So actually the social media thing kind of helped out.
Cool. What's the address of the, how can I get to know about information about your book and where can I find your photography background, I mean website and stuff?
It's cosplayingamerica.com. Simple, easy, right there.
All right, thank you very much. And I know you have another Twitter account that all the LA photographers are following you about.
Oh, that's like a side thing.
Well, would you explain to me that? I mean, it's not really Japan-related stuff, but...
Oh, okay. Well, basically, the thing about Los Angeles is, and New York is, they're both very large photography cities. New York has a very strong photography community, and they're really on the web. While here in Los Angeles, it's not the same. And so what happened is I started Twitter and a blog that covers photography events here in Los Angeles, seminars, workshops, and so forth, aimed at photographers. The problem with LA is it's too big. There's photographers all over the place, there's events all over the place. And it's hard to put everything into one thing. So I kind of combine everything to one website, so it makes it easier for photographers or people who love photography to find out.
What's the address of that one?
Oh, that one's pixfeedla.com, which is pixfeedla.com. Oh, .com, which will actually get you to all the links and everything else.
Cool. I mean, thank you very much.
No worries. Thank you.
All right. Would you introduce yourself?
Yes, I'm Greg Hignight, and I'm a co-founder of Tune in Tokyo.
How about you?
I'm Dell. I'm a co-founder of Tune in Tokyo.
So tell me how you guys started, and then why did you start Tune in Tokyo?
Well, Dell has a background running indie clubs in Los Angeles. He's been DJing and been a promoter for about 10 years. And we noticed in the last few years that the J-Rock scene was really blowing up. However, there were no regular events for people to attend. You know, they would come out anytime a concert went on, or maybe they would go to like an anime convention. But what we wanted to do is we wanted to create an ongoing club experience based around J-Rock, J-Pop, and Global Pop. That's how Tune in Tokyo came into being.
Do you want to add something?
No, I think he pretty much said it all.
So how you guys progress? When did you guys fund it? And how you guys progress from over the course of the year?
Well, about 2 years ago, we were running a Global Pop event. And as that was winding down, we started Tune in Tokyo, which had to focus on Japanese pop. And we did that about a year and a half ago. And since then, we've had successful monthly events, but we've also tried to involve ourselves in other things that are related to Japanese subculture, like cosplay parties, retail launch parties that are related to Japanese goods, like dolls, music, things like that. And we've also started hosting bands as well. And so at a Tune in Tokyo event, you're always going to have DJs spinning global dance pop, but sometimes you might even have an artist from Japan coming out to do a special show.
Cool, that's why you're doing the DJing today as well in a costume, right? So how did you know Ejen?
We met just Ejen kind of around town, kind of running in similar circles. And of course, cosplay is a part of what we do. We try to make it open so that people, if they want to do like Harajuku fashion, Lolita, cosplay, it's kind of anything goes. But definitely we've always been really close to cosplay culture in LA.
So what kind of favorite music, who's your favorite artist?
I'll let Dell take that one first.
Okay. In terms of Japanese artists, my favorite artist is Perfume. I admire Yasutaka Nakata. Anything he does with Perfume, Capsule, Meg, I think is brilliant, and it always gets a good response on the dance floor. In terms of global pop, we've been incorporating a lot of Korean pop into our mixes, and my favorite Korean pop artist is 21.
So I hear Perfume song playing right now too.
That was my selection. Yes.
So where can I get to know about you guys?
Can you ask that again?
Where can I get to know you guys? How do I know where you guys do the event?
Oh, okay, that's easy. Well, we have a home, and it's 2nd Street Jazz in Little Tokyo. That's where we've been since the beginning. They're located kind of like right in the heart of everything. They're about a block away from Anime Jungle and the Cure Shop, which is a big destination for fans of J-Rock, really close to downtown. So we're there every month. And then we also do a couple special events every month. And we're at myspace.com/TuneInTokyoClub. On Facebook, you just look up Tune in Tokyo, and we're always telling everybody not only what's going on with our shows, but any kind of J-Rock, K-Pop show around town. We try to keep everyone apprised of what's going on.
Cool, thank you. Well, I think I went to one of you guys' show in 2nd Street Jazz. It was fun. Lots of people in a costume hanging outside of the 2nd Street Jazz, and when I first saw it, oh, what's going on, 2nd Street Jazz? What, aren't they playing jazz, you know? But I guess you guys brought in some new kind of scene to the 2nd Street Jazz. I think congratulations to you guys.
Thank you.
Yeah. So I guess I'm going to enjoy the music and then enjoy the cosplay party rest of the day. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay.